Good morning. Good morning, Facebook friends and family. Ooh, God is so good. I hope each and every one of you have had a blessed weekend. Just a little nippy in the air, but God is good. He's faithful. He's just. And he has just looked over us in this pandemic. And as we're approaching this election, we're just thanking God for his peace. That covers all our understanding, that we can pray and be healed in his name. We can receive as many blessings in his name. We're going to give God praise today. We had a good sermon on last Monday, being grateful in uncertain times. Woo! Les, thank you, Jesus. Good morning. Good morning to everyone on here today. But we are still in the midst of that last Monday motivation, and I know we are still praising the Lord today, for he is good and his mercy endureth forever. Thank you, Jesus. I hope each and every one of you are fasting on today. We're going to fast today. We're going to fast tomorrow. Initially, let's just do it to 12, but if you want to go longer, go ahead and go longer. But we're going to just be seeking God's face. We're going to ask him to come down here and heal this land, and we're going to ask for his protection. We're going to ask for his covering over us and our families, and we're going to ask for peace. And we're going to come against every demonic activity that is going on right now. Every demonic activity. All in our TV, all outside. Woo, the devil is busy. But guess what? God has given us power to tread over every enemy, every serpent, every demonic spirit. And we must use those power collectively to come together in prayer. So continue to fast with me on today. And I know God is going to hear our voices, and he's going to heal this land. Thank you, Jesus. Good morning again. We're going to be talking about today, not looking back. Okay. As we, in 2 more months, you know, I was thinking of that. In 2 months, we're going to be approaching a new year. Wow. It's already November. And as we approaching And as we approach the new year, we tend to look back on what everything that has happened to us in 2020. And God is telling us, told me to tell you guys, don't look back. Because if you dwell on the things of 2020, then you are not going to be able to move forward and tackle the enemy for what he has set up for us already in 2021. So he want me to encourage you today that don't matter what has happened in 2020, we are still supposed to keep our eyes gazed on him. Because these things that we are going on right now, these are our old things. These are things that will pass away. As we continue to fight the coronavirus and fight all the stuff that's happening in the streets and all the stuff that's going on, he want also to remind us that more is going to go on. More is going to go on as we face the new year. But we can't be ready with that whole armor on if we keep looking back and focusing on what happened in 2020. So I want to get you guys ready today, get you prepared today. I know we're going to talk about it. I know we're going to talk about this pandemic because we've never seen anything like this happen before. But God is saying move from the pandemic. Move from all the other stuff that surrounds our ears and surrounds our TV, because we got to be ready for what's going to happen in 2021. 2021 is going to be a prosperous year. 2021 is going to be a year like never before. But he is calling us to be mindful and be ready for 2021, because we are going to be in a new year, a new beginning, new challenges is going to arise. New commitments, new places in us, and of worship within us, new relationships that we have formed, whether it's in Christ or just natural relationship, new opportunities, new things are going to rise in 2021. But if we're not careful, we will let the things that happened to us in 2020 bring us down, and we will never see God's full advancement in our life. If we don't forget all the negativity that has taken place in 2020, We must be ready as we approach in two more months. Another year, God able us to see two more months, we'll be in another year. Woo! God is saying it is another year, another opportunity, another chance. If you live to see another 22, to see 2021, it'll be another chance for you to get it right. Woo! Don't look back. Don't look back on the things that you lost. Don't look back on failed promises. Don't look back on somebody that hurt you. Don't look back on anything that happened in 2020. He's going to be doing a new thing in you. He's going to be doing a new thing in 2021. And he's saying right now, I'm telling you, don't worry about all the things that happened in 2020. Because what's going to happen in 2021 is not going to be the same old stuff. Woo! He's calling us right now as a people. You're going to have to pray more. Woo! You're going to have to fast more. You're going to have to seek my face more. Woo! Don't forget about 2020. But we must continue to move forward. We must continue to press on to the mark of our calling. Where is our calling, our calling, Malia? What is our calling? Our calling is Christ Jesus. He is the one that is the author and finisher of our faith. He is the Lord of lords and the kings of kings. He's got things, missions, assignments for each of us. We must be ready and be prepared as we go into the new year to be ready. We must be ready at all costs. Woo! We must be ready with putting on our whole armor of God. Don't slack anything. The devil tactics is going to be ramped up in 2021. We must be prepared. We must pray without ceasing. We must not let anyone turn us around. We must keep moving forward, pressing on to that mark, pressing on to the prize of Christ Jesus. God is warning us today that, yes, it was a lot of hardships. Yes, people have lost their jobs. Yes, that economy don't seem like they'll ever get back on its feet. But he said, don't forget, I am still in control. And what happened in 2020 is 2020. As we get ready to focus on a whole new year, we don't know what's going to happen. But God is saying right now to be ready for whatever it is that's going to happen. He wants you to be ready. He don't want you to keep talking about the past. He wants these old things to be passed away and all things within yourself to be made new. Don't worry about 2020. Don't look back to the coronavirus. Woo! Don't look back all the things that you lost. Woo! The Bible said that the Satan come in to steal, kill, and destroy. But he said he gonna go back. He said we got the power to go back into Satan's camp and take back everything that he stole from us. Woo! Don't let 2020 be a damper on your spirits. Don't let 2020 be a year that you lost all your hope. Woo! God is coming back. He's coming back, and he's coming back fierce. He's coming back with force, and he's coming back and letting the sermon the enemy notice. He's going to take back. He's going to protect his people, and he's going to cast Satan down into the fiery furnace. He wants us to be ready for this new year. He wants us to don't hold nothing back against Satan. We need to pray like we never prayed before. Woo! As the economy begins to slowly slip into hands of disembarkment, we don't have no plan, nobody to fix it. But God is saying that he knows everything, and he got the whole situation in the palm of his hand. Will we still be discouraged on a jobless market? Will we still be discouraged on Satan coming in and attacking our family? We will still be discouraged on Satan coming in and attacking our body. He's telling us today that don't be discouraged, for a new time, a new day is coming. As we approach in 2 months, a new year, I want you to know and I want to encourage you today that don't worry about anything that has happened. Don't worry about anything that has happened to you in 2020. God is going to bless you and give you a whole new beginning. Woo! But requiring us to do something, we must put our trust in the Lord. Woo! He's looking for a church. He's looking for people here on this earth that come hell or high water will stand up for him and say, for the Lord I live and for the Lord I die. He ain't coming back for no any and everything. Woo! He's coming back for us. We must continue to be ready. If you prayed every night, go ahead and pray 2 or 3 times a day. Woo! We cannot let our guard up. Satan is coming in like a roaring lion, seeking people on this earth who can, he can come in and trick to devour. Don't let it be one of you. Don't let your guard be down. Don't look back on everything you lost in 2020. God wants your eyes gaze forward on him. Woo! He wants your eyes gaze forward on him. He don't want you to think about everything that you lost. Woo! He don't want you to get discouraged on your past. He's calling us to move forward in everything. Put our trust in him. And he said, if you put your trust in me, I'll give it all back to you. I'll do you like I did Job after he lost everything that he had. I'll do you like I did Job when he lost his family. I'll do you like I did Job when he lost all his cattle. When he got down sick on his deathbed, Job was a faithful man. And everybody told Job to go ahead and I think you should give up on the Lord. I don't think you should put your trust in the Lord no more. Look at how you look right now. You're looking all pitiful in your face. Woo! You barely can walk. And you still want to say and put your trust in this man that you call the Lord God. Woo! But Job said, he said, no matter what the Lord has allowed to happen to me, I'm going to still put my trust in the Lord. Something down inside of me is telling me that I need to hold out just a little bit longer. Woo! Something inside of me telling me that I'm going to get everything I lost. I'm going to go ahead and get it all back. Woo! Job went through a lot. But one thing Job didn't do is count and sit down and think about all the things that he lost. He kept moving forward and putting his trust in the Lord. And after he had suffered a while, woo, look at that verse coming back up again. God established him. Woo! God made Job perfect in all his ways. Woo! Job got back double. He got back double for his trouble. I'm gonna tell you something right now. Don't be sad of all your losses in 2020. Don't be sad that you lost your job. And don't be sad that you can't go to church like you used to. Don't be sad that somebody in your family got sick and died from coronavirus. Woo! Don't be sad. God is saying, lift up your head, all ye gates. Woo! Lift up your hands, because he's coming in to restore power. Woo! It ain't no coincidence that the power is all out right now. We got to look at what's going on in the spiritual. Just like this power in the natural is going out all around the Montgomery, Prattville, Plattsville area, Selma area. God is saying that don't let your power, don't let your spiritual power go out. Woo! Go ahead, go by your bed. If you have to light a lantern, woo! If you have to light a candle, don't let your spiritual power go out. It ain't over. It ain't over. No matter how bad 2020 looked, it's not over. God has the last say so. He has the last word. Don't look back. Don't look back on all the things that has happened. Go ahead and keep your eyes gazed forward to the front. He's going to restore everything that you lost. Keep your trust. Keep your trust and faith in Him. You have to have more trust in Him than you ever did before. Satan ain't gonna want you to get it back. Woo! He ain't gonna want you to get your job back. Woo! He ain't gonna want you to get your spiritual life back like it used to be. He ain't gonna want nothing to come back to you like it once was. But God is saying if you just hold out a little while longer, hold out until 2021, and I'm going to restore everything that you lost back. Woo! Just like I'm going to restore the natural power. I'm going to restore your spiritual power. Woo! Don't look back. Don't worry about it. Be encouraged today. Don't look back. As we go into our scripture really quick this morning in Genesis 19, verse 24, we talk about here the story of Sodom and Gomorrah. The verse 24 says, then the Lord rained upon Sodom and upon Gomorrah brimstone and fire from the Lord out of heaven. And he overthrew those cities and all the plain and all the inhabitants of the city and that which he grew upon the ground. But look right here. But his wife, Lot's wife, looked back from behind her, and she became a pillar of salt. God had told, sending angels down, and told Lot, I'm going to destroy the city. The people don't have no reverence for me. Woo! They're building all kinds of idol gods. I'm going to tell you right now, Lot, I look down on you and your family. I found that you and your family were good people. Woo! I found out that you and your family loved me. Woo! You were faithful of a few things. Woo! Lot, I'm going to send a warning down to you to go ahead and leave before it gets too bad. I don't want nothing to happen to you and your family. Woo! So the angels came down and gave Lot a warning and said, I don't know what you want to do, but I'm going to tell you right now, God has sent me here to tell you he's going to destroy this city and everything that's in it because the people have turned their back against the Lord. The Lord is tired of all such a sin generation, a generation that don't care nothing about what they're doing. As we look at this generation back here in the Bible days, we look at this same generation in the nation. Ooh, a generation that don't even want to say Jesus or God in anything that they do. Ooh, a generation that's building all kinds of idols, idols within their own self. Idols, all kind of monuments of other people and doing all kinds of things and going out and worshiping. But God is looking down on the earth and saying, that's not what I approve of, and I'm going to come down and destroy this nation. Woo! I'm going to tell you right now, when I come down, keep your eyes forward. Don't take your eyes off of the prize, because I'm coming down to restore the nation that's full of sin. I'm coming down to destroy a nation that's full of pride. I'm coming down here to destroy this nation that's full of jealousy. I'm coming down here and destroy this nation that's full of everything but me, that don't have no love in their hearts, that don't have no compassion in their hearts. I'm going to destroy, but I'm going to tell you something right now to all my people. You better be careful not to get caught up in this nation. You better be careful not to caught up in the cares of this world. Because when I destroy it, I'm not taking any hostages. Woo! When I destroy it, I'm not going to change my mind. You better keep your eyes gazed forward on me. You better keep your eyes set on the prize. Because if your eyes is not set on the prize, guess what? I'm going to destroy you just like I did Lot's wife. I'm not taking no sorries. I'm not taking no time to say I want to have another chance. I'm not listening to no pleas and no cries. Woo! Lot's wife, she didn't have time to say, Lord, I'm sorry. She didn't have time to go back and say, oh, I wish I should have never did it. She didn't have no time. She didn't have no time. God did it in a twinkling of an eye. She couldn't let go of a sinless generation. Just like we are today. We so caught up in what's going on the TV. We get so caught up in what's going on our Facebook. We get so caught up in what's going on everything and everybody but the Lord. But the Lord, the Satan is distracting us to make us be busybodies with everything else but with our own selves, with our own chance and opportunity to read our word. But Lord is saying to us and sending me here today as a warning, don't be distracted. Don't let your guard down, because when the time comes, he ain't going to take no hostages. Woo! You ain't going to have no chance to get it right. Don't look back. Don't look back on 2020. Don't look back on the sins and the other people of this nation. Don't look back all the stuff you heard on the TV. Don't look back, because God is calling us to move and keep on, people, moving forward in him, moving forward in all the plans and the things that he has called us to do. He's called us to a nation of such great pain and sorrow. He's telling us right now, people, he wants us to start putting on our whole armor of God. Get ourselves ready as we approach 2021. Don't let your guard down for nobody. Satan is coming. He's going to attack us with all that he got. Woo! You think 2020 was worse? But I'm going to tell you something right now. The time is coming. Just like he said in Revelation, the time is going to come that we're going to be hiding ourselves under a rock. Woo! We're going to want to escape. We're going to want to escape the sinless, the sinful, sinful world, the sinful nation. And we ain't going to have nowhere to hide. We won't have nowhere to go. But I heard him saying at distance that if you be faithful, if you're a woman that loves me, a man that loves me, that when that time come, I'll reach up and I'll grab you. And I'll protect you. I'll put you in my loving arms. I won't cause anything. I won't cause anything. No plague in Psalms 91. No disease to come near you. He said 1,000 may fall at the right hand. 10,000 at the right side. But nothing will come near you. Woo! God is so faithful. Be ready. Put on the whole armor of God. Don't look back on the past. Don't look back on 2020. Don't worry about the hardships. Don't worry about the headache. Don't worry about the pain that it's caused you. God is going to restore everything that the enemy came in and took from us. He's going to restore it. And just like he did Job, he gave Job double for his trouble. Woo! Are we ready to get double? Are we ready to get double for our trouble? Woo! We need to tell old Satan, come on, give it to us. Give us all that you got. Come on and hit me with your best shot. Because if you don't take me out, guess what? If I'm still left standing, I'm going to sit here and wait until my help comes. Woo! I'm going to sit here and wait until my help comes. Because when my help comes from the Lord, He's going to restore everything that you took from me. Woo! Satan. Satan has to bow at the name of Jesus. The Bible said that every tongue must confess and every knee shall bow. Satan would have to bow at the name of Jesus. Call out Satan today for who he is. Go back to the enemy's camp and take back everything that he stole from you in 2020, that he continues to steal and steal from us. But God told me to tell you today that you will get it back. Don't look back. Don't look back, because if you look back into a world of sin, you might not have another chance to ask God to forgive you. I encourage you today to repent. Ask God for whatever it is in 2020 that you may not have done right, that you may have gotten so caught up in that you forgot about Him. But let Him know that you want to focus now on, henceforth, to 2021. You want to focus on a new and prosperous year. And everything that you lost, you're not going to worry about. You're not going to cry over it. You're not going to mourn over it. You're not going to let nothing steal your joy. God is saying, don't worry about it, that we've been made endure. We're going to endure. We may not see it in the midnight hour. You may not see it at 2 o'clock in the morning. You may not see anything changing at 3 o'clock in the morning. But God told me to tell you, when the sun comes up, when you can see a new day breaking ahead, I can see a new day, there seems to be a change and a shift in the atmosphere. He's coming back. He's coming back in the morning to restore hope. Woo! He's going to come back in this morning to restore joy. He's coming back to restore all that was lost, that wants to be found. He's coming back. Don't you all look back on these things that has happened to us in our past. Yes, 2020 was a year we never would have thought we would ever see. I know I would have never thought I would see a pandemic in my lifetime. I would have never thought I'd see the economy so bad that you can barely can afford a loaf of bread. I never thought I would see anything like this. But God is reminding me every day that Marlena, don't worry about 2020, because you need to be ready for 2021. I told you in my word in Revelation that I was soon to come. And I don't care about all this stuff that you have that's happened to you. I'm not going to let you harp on it, because I got more things that I want you to do. I got another mission and more people out here that needs to be saved. Woo! Don't harp. Don't harp on everything that you lost. I know it was hard. Trust me. I experienced loss and all kinds of things, my own self. But guess what? I have to get up every morning and put on my clothes. I have to get up every morning and comb my hair. I have to get up every morning with strength, sometimes feeble body, don't feel like doing anything. But I look up and I pray unto the Lord and I say, Lord, you gave me one more day. Woo! You gave me one more day, and I'm going to make this day worth something. I'm going to get up in pain in my body and praise you. I'm going to get up with pain in my body and still say, I'm going to make a difference in somebody's life. Woo! It's something you can do to move forward, to press your way forward to that mark. It's something that you can do. Continue to do it, people. My brothers and sisters, continue to do it. Don't let the 2020 be a year of discouragement. Don't let 2020 get you so far down that you can't get back up. God is going to restore everything that the enemy stole from you. Just hold on. Don't lose hope. Don't lose your faith. Don't be like Lot's wife. Most importantly, please don't look back. Don't look back to a nation full of sin. Don't look back to people that's talked about you behind your back. Don't look back for people that don't have a heart and don't know how to say thank you when you help them do something, take their groceries to the car. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Keep your eyes focused on the prize. The prize is Christ Jesus. Thank you so much. This is an encouragement word this morning, reminding us with all the things, the troubles that we all have had, experienced in our lives, God is still letting us know that it's not over. We must continue to remain resilient. We must continue to remain strong. We don't know what's ahead, so we must pray without ceasing. We must fast every chance that we get, seeking God, seeking Him for answers, seeking Him for healing in this land, seeking Him for protection, seeking Him for more passion and love to come upon this nation. God is calling us as a nation to prayer. He don't care about what's going on right now. He has a situation in the palm of His hands. Don't worry about it. Don't look back. Look forward. Look and press to the mark of our higher calling. Our higher calling is in Christ Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Woo! Don't look back. As the song says, move forward. That you won't look back. Continue to move forward. Don't look back. Don't worry about it. You're going to get it back. He's going to give you double for your trouble. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Thank you for joining me today. Thank you as we continue to march, as we continue to fight, as we continue to pray for our nation. Continue to fast with me on this week. Continue to do all you need to do to make sure you're in the right place at the right time. Don't look back and be like Lot's wife. Don't get caught up in what's going on in this world. Let us really quickly go into the Lord with our morning prayer for the week. Let us pray. Father God, thank you on this day. Woo! We give you praise on today, Father. We give you glory on today, Father. And Father, I thank you right now for this glorious and prosperous word that you have given me, Father. Father, we get sometimes so caught up in everything that's going on around us. And as we look at this year, starting in March of this year, everything has been seemed like a downfall. And every time we turn on the TV, every time we talk on the phone with our friends, we talk about what's going on. But Father, I thank you so much today that you reminded me to tell the people, stop talking about it. We must continue to move forward. The war and the fight against the enemy is not over. We must continue to press on to the mark of our higher calling. Our higher calling is in Christ, the Lord our God, the Lord our God and Savior. We must continue to move forward in the plans and dreams and goals that He has for us in our lives. We must continue to have love and compassion for the people. We must continue to show all kinds of remorse and bring people as never before to Christ. We must continue to move forward in the things that God has designed and planned for each of our lives. He's telling us today, reminding us today that don't worry about 2020. Don't worry about all the losses you've had. Don't worry about the job market. Don't worry about the deaths that you had in your family. He said that He's the Lord that restores all joy. He is the Lord that restores all hope. And just like he got you through it in 2020, he's going to get you through it to 2021. Woo! As we approach it in two more months, we ask the Lord, we're not going to wait for the new year. We want to go ahead and get ready right now. Woo! We're not going to wait. We're not going to wait. We're going to go on and start fasting and praying right now. Woo! We're not going to wait till the new year comes. We're going to go ahead and praise the Lord while we already got a chance. Don't look back on what happened in 2020. God is reminding us and getting us ready for a new year of hope, a new year of restored joy, a new year of restored everything that the devil has stole from you. He's telling me to tell you today in 2021, all your hardships, all the things that you lost and the devil came in and stole from you in the midnight hour. He said he's going to restore it all back to you. Woo! He's not a man that he should lie. Just like he did it for Job, he'll do it the same for you. Continue to press on. Press on when you don't feel like it. Lord, give us the strength to press on when we have pains in our bodies. Lord, give us the strength to press on when we get bad news from the doctor. Woo, Lord, we want to be able to continue to press on because we know as long as you give us breath on this earth that our work is not done. Woo, we want to be ready. We want to be ready when Jesus comes. Lord, strengthen our bodies. Strengthen our minds. I pray for each person right now on the sound of my voice. Lord, get us ready. Don't let us look back with the cares of this world. Don't let us look back with the cares of all the things that happened in 2020. You've given us an opportunity right now to keep on moving forward. We must. We don't have a choice. We must continue to move forward in everything God has for us in 2021. As we continue to mourn losses, listen to all the headlines that plays our TV, we're not going to be discouraged. We're not going to let it get us down. We're going to go in to our secret room and give everything to the Lord God. Make our requests known to him. He said he will hear our cry and he will answer us by and by. Lord, I thank you. Thank you for this great word. I pray that someone will share the word today and that somebody will be encouraged today. Bless each and every person. Lord, you know everything. Meet every need. Heal bodies right now in the sound of my voice. Right now, touch their bodies in the name of Jesus. Touch it, Father, in the name of Jesus. Give back, restore joy back right now in the name of Jesus. Give somebody their joy back. Give somebody their hope back right now under the sound of my voice in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for this word. Thank you, Father, for another day. We will continue to give you praise. We will continue to move forward in our daily life, each and every day this week. Give us a blessed and prosperous week. Give us hope, restored joy, restored love on this week. And most importantly, Lord, let us be mindful to give you all glory and praise for all the good things that you have done. In Jesus' holy and precious name we pray, amen. 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 Don't look back. He's calling us to keep on moving forward. Don't look back, y'all. We are almost there. Don't give up. Don't give up. We are almost there. He said, after we've suffered a while, then he will establish us. He will make us perfect in all his ways. Keep your hope. Keep your joy. Don't be discouraged. You're going to get it back. He's going to give it all back. Put all your trust in him. Put all your trust in him. Continue to fast today and tomorrow with me. I'm going to go to at least noon today. You guys fast however long you do it. Just whatever you feel in your heart to do. As you're fasting, pray. Pray. Go take 10 minutes in your closet. Take 10 minutes outside. Pray unto the Lord. Asking God for restored hope, healing, deliverance in this nation. And we want to have a peaceful week this week. We don't want nothing to steal our joy this week. Thank you so much. Hey, new messages is on YouTube. Go out there. It don't take but a second, you guys. Check me out. Follow me. Just follow me on YouTube. You don't even have to listen to it all the time. Just keep the subscribe button and follow me. I really, really would appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Thank you for watching. Y'all have a blessed week. God is good. Praise the Lord today, for his mercy endures forever. Woo!